Welcome everyone to another First Impressions. Today we are going to be taking a look at Gunbrella. Okay, full disclosure here. Only reason why this even caught my attention is just the title itself. Just look at it. Gunbrella. It's like the stupidest thing I have seen all day. But you know what? It's absolutely genius. A gun and an umbrella. Functional, fashionable, put it together, you got yourself a deadly weapon. Now, I haven't actually seen the trailer itself. I don't know what the game is about. Like I said before, just the title just gripped me. It put its claws into me. It put its umbrella hook onto my neck and just pulled me in. I have to know what this game's about. So yeah, this is the First Impressions. Let's jump right into it. Devolver Digital. They always publish great indie games. I'm sure that this isn't going to be any different. It's going to be spectacular. I believe. Barbie. But want to know who killed your wife? Marl has the answer. I'm truly sorry.
You mother effer!
Yo, the movement. Umbrella. It's Mary Poppins. Counter ability, counterplay. I like it. It's a genius. The movement is just, I can already tell like right off the bat, whoever these developers are, they got the movement down. Like it's so precise. I can already just tell. I love that NPC art too. Freaking Gunbrella, man. Just a giant rat now? I don't even know what the frick is happening. But I am intrigued. I got some swearing. I like it. Gunbrella! All they're missing is a is a tagline right here. Gunbrella. Today, it will be raining bullets or something stupid like that. No, for real though, absolutely genius. Gunbrella, the title. I mean, it got me to watch it. It got me hooked. It grabbed this little umbrella hook. It hooked me by the neck and dragged me in. I am in 100%. Okay, so again, this isn't some super in-depth analysis analyzing every single form of pixels. Like, this is just the first impressions, and I gotta say, right off the bat, ladies and gentlemen, my friends, boys and girls of all ages, you know what's genius about this? Okay, just take a look at this. What's genius about this? I mean, there's a lot of great things happening here. But, and I know this may seem like such a small thing, but this right here, the choice to use, what is that, a scarf? Sure. A scarf. Why not? Okay. The choice for him to have this scarf is such an important piece of this design. Primarily because when you have a scarf or something long, whether it's hair, an article of clothing, this is such an important design element, especially when it comes to a 2D platformer, that 2D action adventure platformer such as this, and at the pace that this game is going at. And it's such an important thing because this helps reinforce this idea of speed and directional input. Just look at the way, I don't even know the character's name, Gunbrella Man is able to dash and weave, but it's always so clear. Like every time he jumps, every time he moves, it's always clear what direction he's heading. Yeah, just look at that. It's a visual reinforcement to the player showing, hey, you're moving at this speed. You're moving at this direction. We're going to go win. Gunbrella in hand. And it is such an important design aspect. I mean, just the weapon itself is absolutely genius. Like I know I would say how stupid it was, but it's stupid in a good way. And I freaking love how this gun umbrella is being used. Like, when the... Just watching the trailer you're using it in so many different ways. You're using it for melee. You're using it for counterattack, for movement. And I think, and I could be wrong, I don't know the deep inner workings and mechanics of the legendary Gunbrella, because I've never held one recently. So, but I'm guessing when you have the umbrella out, you know, when you have it out like this and you press the attack button or the firing button, wherever you're pointing it, I'm guessing that's the trajectory you're going to be going. It's such a genius design. When a weapon can provide not only fast, quick, glorious kills, and it has the ability to function as a movement utility, a movement tool, you know you have a great weapon. And it's a freaking Gunbrella, man. It's a gun and a umbrella. It's genius. And the art style too, I freaking love pixel art that does a lot with very little. Like, if you look at just this room, for instance, it's very basic with the pixel art, but it reads so well. Like you take one look at this and you're like, man, that's a freaking workshop station. That's an old man. And then, of course, as you're talking to the character, it gets more detailed with the character portraits. I freaking love it. And man, look at this guy. Just look at this. Look at this. Look at this lovely man right here. Saying hi. He doesn't give a F. He just really loves what he does. Like, this is someone I would bring my Gunbrella to and let him repair and upgrade it. I don't know about you guys. And yeah, it looks like a very fun 2D adventure game. Oh, one other thing too. Oh, of course, you know, you have to have the minecart level. Let's see, where's my example I was going to say? Another important thing too, especially if it is going to be using text to convey storytelling, I freaking love, and this should be like a requirement for any 2D style game that wants to do storytelling. A lot, it's just like that. A lot can be accomplished with conveying character emotion simply by doing things such as changing the size of the text, making it jiggle, wiggle, 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 jiggle, jiggle just a little bit. Because it helps reinforce what the character is saying without them actually having proper voice acting. And this game does it well. I freaking love it. Was it? So developer is Doinksoft. Okay, Doinksoft, I see you. You guys have a great product here. I haven't even played it, but again, this is just the first impressions, and it looks fun. It looks amazing. Design element wise, just character designs, this noir looking world. I don't even know if this is that the look what they're going for, noir. Oh, there you go. Gunbrella is a noir punk action adventure set in a world dependent on a rapidly diminishing natural resource. Players take the role of a gruff woodsman on a quest for revenge, armed with the mysterious Gunbrella, a firearm that doubles as an umbrella. Hell yeah. His investigation becomes entangled with the inner workings of ghouls and gangsters, cops and cultists, and the fallout of corporate exploitation. This looks great. This looks fun. I'm down. I just noticed it doesn't have an actual release date. Let's go to their website. Do we have an actual release date, or does it just say 2023? All right. What about Steam? Is it going to say it on Steam? 2023. Well, that's unfortunate. Either way, this game looks like a blast. It looks like fun. And yeah, that's all I got to say about it. Let me know if you guys are, any of you are interested about picking up some Gunbrella, you know, adding it to your arsenal of weaponry that you can use to go outside and stay away from the rain. So let me know if you're going to pick this game up. It looks like a great time. Looks really fun. But yeah, that is the end of this first impressions. And thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to like, subscribe, comment, check out our podcast too. It's always fun times over there. Video Game Book Club, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, if there are any other games you'd like me to do a first impressions on, just leave it in the comment section below. I'm always looking for something new to play, something new to watch, something new to nominate for Video Game Book Club. So yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. You take care. Have a good one. Keep on gaming, and I'll catch you in the next episode or next first impressions video. Take care, everybody. Amen.